desegregation is against the Bible. I find my scripture for this in Genesis 9:27, where God did segregate and separate the three sons of Noah.
They are not going to get equal treatment.
Move on. Get back on the sidewalk. Move back then. You are blocking the traffic and you
interfering
the line.
Sir, I don't want you to leave. We have come to register to vote. We're willing to be beaten for democracy.
Today marks the beginning of a determined, organized, mobilized campaign.
Certainly, I cannot stand here without thinking of 1955 and 56, when some 50,000 Negro citizens of this city decided that it was ultimately more honorable to walk in dignity than ride in humiliation.
Hello, Montgomery. 20 minutes after 10, I'm Ace Anderson behind the mic with the sounds you like. Here we go with John Lee Hooker.
Boom, 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 boom. I'm gonna shoot you right down. Right off of your feet.
I'm 5 years old, and I'm riding on the bus, and I can't sit down, and I'm asking my brother why. And then, you know, a white guy would get on and sit in the seat. And I said, they sitting there.
That was the law back then.
Oh, yeah.
On the 5th of December, 1955, fine, dignified, disciplined, courageous seamstress from this community was sitting down on a bus. Sister Rosa Parks, with dignity and discipline, said in substance that the cup of endurance has run over. I can take it no longer. Martin Luther, back in the 16th century, who said, here I stand and I can do none other, so help me God. It was Rosa Parks who on the 1st of December said, here I sit and I can do none other, so help me God.
I had never even heard of Dr. King until that night. And I never got emotional in the church before in my life until that night. And I screamed out to the top of my voice, Lord, you have sent us a leader.
Are you ready for the question?
Now, the main question at the meeting was whether we should continue with the boycott.
All in favor, let it be known by standing on your feet.
Get back. I hope built the country, and I fought for it too. Now I'll get that you can see what a black man have to do. This is, if you white, you're all right. If you brown, stick around, but as you black, brother. Get back.
Another thing I want to say to you is that hate isn't our weapon either. And I'm not talking now about a weak love. It would be nonsense to urge oppressed people to love their oppressors in an affectionate sense. I'm not talking about that. Too many people confuse the meaning of love when they go to criticizing the love ethic. I'm talking about a love that is so strong that it becomes a demanding love. I'm talking about a love that is so strong that it organizes itself into a mass movement and says somehow, I am my brother's keeper. And he's so wrong that I'm willing to suffer and die if necessary to get him right and to see that he's on the wrong road.
your orders to disperse. See that they disperse.
Let me just.